I don't think there is an other side here, frankly. You know, we get so used to this discussion about this side and that side. The two sides could just be simply the right side and the wrong side. We don't know what causes autism. I mean, that's fair to say. We're not sure as a scientific community what causes autism, but we know that vaccines do not.
Right.
And I think it's just important to say that as succinctly as I just did, and not to say, look, I'm going to delay the vaccines. You hear doctors coming on saying, you know, it's okay, let the parents choose. Of course, I'm a parent. I have three kids. I made that choice. I got them vaccinated on schedule, on time, to protect their health and to protect the health of the people around them. I also want to show you one other thing here, and this is a little bit of a nuanced point, this other graphic I have, looking at the way that we used to vaccinate in the past, how we vaccinate now, and look at how autism rates have sort of changed since that time, if we can put that graphic up. But basically, it's showing that in the past, look back there in the 1960s, we gave a lot more in terms of vaccine load to kids' bodies. Look at 3,500 times more. And then at some point, sort of in the late 90s, we started to give lower doses of vaccines to try and get the same results. But here's my point. Throughout that time, autism rates continued to go up. So despite the fact that the vaccines themselves have gone down in terms of amount, autism rates have gone up. So there really is no link. Someone could make the argument that vaccines have actually been protective against autism. So it's really, there's nothing there. And I worry about that as a father, and I gave my kids vaccines. I think that's really important.